Tanya.
Lori and Joe, a lot of people were surprised to learn that Eddie Johnson was actually still on the CPD payroll. When he was fired as police superintendent, he went back to his old rank of lieutenant, which means he was still a civil servant. Well, we have just learned about 20 minutes ago from the mayor's office that he has now officially resigned that position and is no longer on the CPD payroll. It is a stunning development after 3 days of shocking news for a career that has spanned more than three decades.
I think she was right to fire him from the beginning.
Alderman Ray Lopez, a frequent critic of Mayor Lori Lightfoot, now siding with her when it comes to her stunning decision to fire Eddie Johnson. But Lopez took it a step further, questioning Johnson's credibility. The Sun-Times is reporting several CPD employees are under investigation for taking part in a cover-up to protect Johnson.
If you are involved in this cover-up to protect yourself, and if you have enabled two dozen command staff and employees to be a part of that, that absolutely fuels the speculation about the code of silence, which he said he's never experienced, but is now exploiting to try and keep his job as long as possible.
Alderman Gilbert Villegas, Mayor Lightfoot's floor leader, also agreed with the mayor firing Johnson, but tried to show some compassion for the former superintendent.
Superintendent Johnson, with 30 plus years with the Chicago Police Department, came through the ranks, promoted more African American Latinos than any other superintendent. And so I'm not going to throw him under the bus for one mistake.
But that one mistake could reportedly cost others their jobs too.
Obviously, the investigation of Eddie Johnson wasn't just about him. It involved the conduct of other people, and that investigation is ongoing.
Alderman Patrick Thompson is over the 11th Ward. That's where Johnson lives and where he was found slumped over the wheel. He says he's concerned about the leaks of information to the media concerning the investigation, but he's more focused on the future and what the interim superintendent Charlie Beck brings to the table.
The week before, we were talking about how we're missing some of these time frames for the consent decree. And we now have a interim superintendent who has lived through that in Los Angeles, who's going to help lead us and sort of put the building blocks on addressing those issues that we have to do in the consent decree.
Again, late word from the mayor's office this evening that Eddie Johnson has officially retired from the Chicago Police Department and is no longer on the payroll. I'm live this evening in the loop at City Hall. Tanya Francis.